Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll be introducing spreadsheet essentials, relative and absolute cell references, formatting numbers, and entering math formulae into Excel. Spreadsheet applications help users calculate and analyze numerical data. Data is arranged within a matrix of cells. Each one of these boxes is called a cell. And this matrix of cells is called a sheet. These cells are arranged in columns, designated by letters of the alphabet, and rows, designated by numbers. A particular cell can be referenced by its column letter, followed by its row number. This reference appears in the name box in the top left corner of the sheet. This cell is A2, this cell is C4, and this cell is B1. A cell can hold text, a numerical value, or a formula to calculate a value. We can edit the content of a cell directly in the cell or in the formula bar across the top of the sheet. Pressing the Enter key or clicking the check mark will confirm the change and update the cell. Pressing the Escape key or clicking the X will cancel the change. Let's enter a formula to add these two numbers. Formulae will always start with an equal sign to indicate a calculation is required. We can click the cell with the first number, type a plus sign, and click the cell with the second number. We could also type the cell references if we wanted to. When we press the Enter key, the sum is calculated and displayed. When editing in the formula bar, Excel will color each cell reference differently and highlight the corresponding cell with that color. This helps identify cells related to the formula being edited. A huge benefit of spreadsheets is that they auto-update the calculated values. When we make a change to one of these values, the calculated sum is updated. Here are some other basic arithmetic operations and their operators. For powers, one uses a caret to indicate the exponent. As we see here, text is aligned left by default, while numbers are aligned right. We can easily change the horizontal alignment if we wish. If we want a cell's contents to act like text, not a number and not a formula, prefix the value with an apostrophe. This is useful if you're entering numerical codes such as a student ID or formulae that you want to be seen, not computed. By default, text that is too large for a single cell will overflow into adjacent cells. We can have the text wrapped to multiple lines, and we can adjust the size of the column and row. We can also adjust the vertical alignment of the cell's contents. Suppose we want to organize our work over multiple sheets. We can add sheets. We can rename a sheet by double-clicking its tab. We can even make a copy of a sheet, delete a sheet, and rearrange the sheets. The spreadsheet file, or collection of sheets, is called a workbook. If you are writing a formula that references a cell on another sheet, simply click that sheet's tab and select the cell as usual. You'll see that the cell is referenced using the sheet name, followed by an exclamation mark, followed by the cell reference. You could also type this in, too. Don't worry if you change the sheet name later, the formula will be updated. Once you have a formula in one cell, you can automatically fill in adjacent cells. In this example, the third column is the sum of the other two. After I enter the formula for the top cell in the third column, I can click and drag the square in the lower right corner of the cell. This will automatically fill in the corresponding formula in the adjacent cells. If I already have data in an adjacent column, I can use a shortcut. Simply double-click on the square, and the cells will be filled in to match the length of the adjacent column. But if there is an empty cell, it will limit the fill length. To see all the formulae at once, we can switch to Formula View. We can do that from the Formulas tab on the ribbon. We can also toggle formula view by pressing Control and Acute Accent. That's the key above the Tab key on your keyboard. On macOS, use Command instead of Control. Just like in other applications, you can copy data to the clipboard and paste it elsewhere. But it's a little different in spreadsheets. Here, the dashed border indicates the data that was copied. By default, it's the formula for the cell that gets copied, not the value. This can be changed using the Paste Options pop-up menu. Here, I'm going to select to paste the source value. Notice how the dashed border disappeared? Performing any action other than paste, even saving your work, will clear the clipboard. Let's copy that cell again. Here, I'm going to keep the default paste and keep the formula. Note, however, that the formula has changed. The cell references have been changed to reflect the location of the new cell. The original cell was the product of the two cells to its left. The formula for the copied cell has been updated to reference the two cells to its left. These cell references are called relative cell references. They change relative to the location of the cell. But what if you don't want them to change? Absolute references do not change when copied. You can specify an absolute reference by putting a dollar sign before the column letter, before the row number, or both. Putting a dollar sign before only the column or row will keep that value constant while allowing the other to change. The contents of a cell can be formatted to represent a specific type of data. Text typically isn't affected by formatting. Numbers can be formatted and rounded to a specific number of decimal places. You can increase and decrease the number of decimal places. If your numerical data represents percentages, choose the percent format to have the value automatically multiplied by 100 and appear with a percent sign. If your numerical data represents money, you can select the currency or accounting format. The only difference between the two is the alignment of the dollar sign. You also have the option of selecting other currencies. There are more formats available, and I encourage you to experiment with them. Because spreadsheets are so adept at performing calculations, mathematical equations and formulae are often entered to be computed. However, sometimes, operators or extra parentheses must be explicitly added to eliminate ambiguities or false assumptions. Here, we have three columns of values for three variables. Suppose we have the following equation to calculate y. We understand that the lack of an operator between a and the first parenthesis implies multiplication, but we need to explicitly enter the multiplication operator for Excel. At the end of the equation, the raised baseline of 2 over x indicates the entire term is the exponent. But when we enter the formula in Excel, that distinction is lost. We need to surround 2 over x with parentheses. Otherwise, Excel will assume the exponent is 2 and the resulting power is to be divided by x, which is not what we want. In the next video, we'll continue looking at Excel. Thanks for watching.